Let's say Alice and Bob have this wheat-shaped stick, and then they break it up. They don't look at the pieces, so one would have the big piece and the other one would have the small piece. Now we send Bob to Andromeda Galaxy, because why not? And then he looks at his piece. It's a bigger piece. And instantly he knows that Alice would have the smaller piece. There's nothing surprising about that, because it was established on the Earth itself that one would have the big piece and one would have the small piece. Now, quantum entanglement is much weirder. It says when we break the stick, it's simultaneously in a state where Bob have the small piece and Alice has the bigger one, and Bob would have the big piece, Alice has the small piece. It is completely in what we call a superposition, but it has to match. They have to fit together to make the original stick, right? But it's not actually determined who has the big piece yet, and quantum mechanics allows that. So Bob and Alice's stick have to be entangled in such a way that they have to fit together correctly to make the original wheat stick. Now suppose Bob takes a look and finds out that he has the big piece, but what happened is somehow he seemingly forced faster than speed of light communication from Andromeda to the Earth instantaneously. He forced Alice's state to also assume a precise state. He instantaneously know that Alice has the smaller piece of stick, and that's that. But he doesn't know whether Alice has looked at it yet or not. So the big question here is, can you communicate from Andromeda to Earth this way? No, maybe not. Bigger piece information was communicated nonetheless, so Alice looks at her piece and instantaneously she sees the smaller one, but she doesn't know that it was her who collapsed the wave function. And so for Alice to tell Bob, she still would have to send you a mail in a post or some signal that at this time I looked at the piece, which obviously won't be faster than speed of light, but neither of them would know who was the one who did it. Because it's really not communication faster than light, it's kind of knowledge faster than light. You can force the stick to assume a specific state faster than speed of light, and you could learn about it later. This is a quantum phenomena called entanglement. It's what happens when two quantum particles interact. And what results from that is those particles, once they have interacted, they are entangled. And it means that their quantum states are interdependent. If one is in particular state, and then the other one has to be in some other particular state, depending on the kind of entanglement they have. So let's take electrons and not sticks. And electrons have quantum property called spin, which you don't really need to know anything about. I did another video of spin if you want to check it out. The spin of an electron can have values. An electron can be spin up or spin down. And if the electrons become entangled, then this may create a situation where those two spins are correlated, such that if one of the electrons has a spin up, then the other one would have a spin down. Now this is a prediction of quantum mechanics. However, here's the complication, because Niels Bohr suggested that in case of quantum particles, it's not the fact that they have this property, spin or whatever. They only have that property with a fixed value when we observe it. So for these entangled electrons, if we think of sending them out to Alice and Bob, Bohr said they don't have a fixed orientation of their spin. All we can say is that those spins are correlated. So if Alice then measures her electron and finds it has spin up, then Bob will have a spin down. But that spin wasn't determined until Alice measured it. And this is where Einstein felt there was a problem. Because it was as if the act of Alice measuring her electron spin somehow affected Bob's spin. So that once Alice had found the spin to be spin up, somehow magically seemed to sort of transmit some kind of influence to Bob's spin to make sure that it was spin down. This is the most famous spooky action at a distance. Einstein, Podolsky and Rosen then suggested that there has to be some alternative to this, because it is impossible for any signal, any information to be transmitted faster than light. You can't have this instantaneous action at a distance. And so Einstein said that what must be going on instead is that all along these two electrons had some property that somehow fixed their spins already. It's just that it was a property that we couldn't measure. He called them hidden variables. How do we know if that's due to hidden variables or just quantum mechanics? Well, then Bell came in and gave his inequality. Violating that inequality implied that there is no such thing as hidden variables. That's whole another topic for another video. The main point is quantum mechanics turns out to be true.